वेलकम टू पुनर्वसी टेक्नोलॉजीज। www.punarvasi.com इज माय वेबसाइट। आई यूज टू राइट डिफरेंट स्टेप बाय स्टेप प्रोसीजर्स ऑन SAP बेसिस एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन इन दिस वेबसाइट। मेनी पीपल गॉट बेनिफिटेड फ्रॉम माय आर्टिकल्स। माय नेम इज राज, SAP बेसिस इंटरनेशनल ट्रेनर। आई हैव ट्रेन्ड स्टूडेंट्स इन मोर देन 50 कंट्रीज। In this video, I'll show you how to schedule background job in SAP system using start condition event based. Log on to SAP system. SAP Easy Access screen will be displayed like this. First, you have to create an event to perform this particular experiment. To create an event, the T code will be used, SM64. So this is the initial screen of the events, background events, overview and administration. Just click on the create button from this and name your event as my underscore event is the event name, and description you can type like this, my own event. And don't select the system. System event cannot be released, cannot be triggered, so that just you have to leave this checkbox and click on the save button to save the event. So the event will be saved here like this, customer my underscore event, my own event. Okay, keep this particular screen as it is. We'll come back again to trigger this particular event to start the, to release the job. Okay, just click on the new create new sessions button to schedule a job. SM36 is the T code for scheduling background job. I have shown you how to schedule background job with the start condition time dependent. Now let us create a job using event dependent. So job name will be anything like this, event underscore 00, and the job class is C, it is default, and target server no need to select, because only one target server is available here. So that whatever the server is available, that will be that particular server will perform this particular job. Okay, now once you provide all these details, click on the save button to save the job. As soon as you save the job, it will ask you to, it will open another screen to create the step. Okay, you need to create the step using the above program. Again, you can use the same above program which we have used in earlier video, that is RSPFPAR is the program name, and you can select the variant of this particular program. Select the variant by clicking on this button, and the variant which we have created earlier, so that is this RDISP underscore paras, double click on it. And once you get that variant here, just click on the save button so that the job step is created. Now just click on the go back button from here so that it will go back to the defined background job screen, and the job steps, one step successfully defined, and the job start condition is not yet specified. You have to specify the job start condition. So you can click on the start condition button from the application toolbar to specify the time dependent or event dependent. In this exercise, you have to click on the event dependent, that is after an event. Click on the after event, and you need to specify the event which you want to specify to start this particular job. Just click on this button so that the my event which we have created while starting this video, you have to select that, and parameter is not required. Just click on the check button to check the event, whether the event is available or not, it will check, and click on the save button to get the start condition, that is after event. That means this particular job event underscore 00 will be released only when this particular event is triggered. Okay, now the status is scheduled. Okay, just click on the save button. Still it will be in the scheduled status. You can view the job status from SM37 T code, and the job is released, but the job status is released means it is scheduled and released, But when the event is triggered, then only the job will start. That means it will come to the status active and then it will be come to finished status. Okay. So let us see the job monitor, that is SM37 T code, and select schedule, and you have to select the start condition also. Here after an event, just select this star from here and click on the execute button, so that all event dependent jobs will be displayed. And here the event underscore 00 first status is scheduled and then it is released, and it will be in the released status only forever, like until that particular event is triggered. Okay, once the event is triggered, the job will be started and it will be completed. Okay, so let us start that particular job and just open another session to view the job monitor screen, SM37, and select this star, click on the execute button so that the status can be viewed from this screen. And this is the screen for triggering the event. Okay, from here you will trigger the event. Just it is the customer, so this is the customer my event, and you have to click on trigger button from here. So click on the trigger button and click on the trigger, so that triggered. Now click on the refresh button here to see the status finished. That means that particular job is started and it is finished. Now you can select this particular job and click on the spool button from the application toolbar and select the spool request and click on the display button to view the content of that particular job output. So in this way you can schedule background jobs in an SAP system with start condition event based. Okay, I hope you understood about this experiment. If you have any questions or doubts, you can leave your comments in my website, that is punarvasi.com, www.punarvasi.com, or you can also comment on this video. I will try to answer your questions. Thanks for watching.